Hello, I'm Jack. Welcome to my channel, Practical Programming with Dr. Su. In this video series, you will learn everything you need to get started with WGPU graphics program in Rust. The examples discussed so far will apply a fixed color by assigning a desired color value in the fragment shader. In this video, I will explain how to use the Colormap to render 3D surfaces. Surfaces play an important role in various applications, including computer graphics, games, and 3D data visualization. In some graphics and chart applications, we need a custom color map to achieve special visual effects. In fact, the color map is just the table or list of colors that are organized in some desired fashion. We can create a custom color map with an m×3 color matrix, with each rule representing RGB values. The rule index can represent by width data of a 2D chart or height of a 3D surface plot. For a given color map matrix, the color data values can be linearly scaled to the color map. Here shows the color strips generated using color maps that we will create in this example. These color strips consist of 11 color maps. You can see that each color map has a familiar color map name. For example, first one is HSV, second is hot, cool, spring, summer, and jet, and so on. Here we will use the git tool to clone the source code used in the last example, and then make corresponding changes to that source code to build the project used in this example. Now, let's start Visual Studio Code directly from Windows Start menu from here. This is a Visual Studio Code interface. Now, let's start a new terminal window. Let's cd into a folder called code. From this folder, we make a new directory called wgpu13 and cd into it. Now we can clone the source code used in the last video with the command git clone wgpu12. After this command, leave a space and a period. This will place all our source code in the current folder. Now run this command. We can check direct. You can see the source code is indeed in the current folder. Now we can open this folder from Visual Studio Code, open folder, code, wgpu13. Here contains the source code used in the last video. We can easily create a custom color map using simple mathematic formula. Here I will provide several commonly used color maps using various m×3 color map array. Now add a new Rust file called colormap.rs to the src folder. Add a new file called colormap.rs. Now add a following code to this file. This code contains a new function called colormapData. Inside this function, you can see each colormap consists of 11 RGB color arrays. For example, for HSV, you can see 1, 2, and 11 array. Each array contains RGB value. You can see RGB 3 values. You can see we have a family color map name, HSV, hard, Q, and the default is jet here. In this color map data function, we assume that these 11 color arrays are uniformly distributed in the range of 0 and 1. For example, here is color 0 because we use the color. You can see here the 0 component represents the color at 0 location, while colors 5 from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this one represent a color at 0.5 location, and so on. However, we have to use interpolation approach to get a color at 0.55 or any other arbitrary locations, because in the other arbitrary locations, we don't have a definition for the color RGB values. So we have to use the interpolation methods to get the value. For our specifically arranged color map array, as shown here, we can easily implement a linear color interpolation function. Now, we can add a new color interpolation function added to here. We call the color interp function. This function accepts an argument t. You can see here, this multiple input, the t, whose value is in the range of minima and maxima, in between of this range. It allows you to interpolate a color for any arbitrary t value. Inside this function, we first get the color array. You can see we get a color array by calling the color map data methods with the color map name here. And then make sure that input argument t is in the range of minima and maxima. Here we also normalize the t to the range of 0 and 1. Use this formula. And next, we interpolate a color for the t value using this formula here. This function returns RGB arrays with each color component in the range of 0 and 1. So it should return the color RGB. Now we can save this file and close it. Next, we need to make some changes to the seeder code because we want to incorporate lighting and color map into the seeder. In addition, we need to apply the light to both sides of a 3D surface, since most of the surfaces are not closed 3D objects. So we need to apply the light to both sides of the surface. From the SRC folder, open the seeder.wgsl file. Now we need to replace its content with the new code. This seeder is very similar to that used in the last few videos, except that in addition to the vertex and the normal data, you can see the input, the position, and normal data. We also add the color data at location 2 to our vertex seeder. Inside the VS main function here, we process this color data and store the output in the vColor variable. You can see the color here, the vColor, defined in the output structure. The vColor is output. In the fragment seeder, we use the processed color data, that is V color, as our object primary color to obtain the final color. You can see inside here the final color. We use the V color as input. This ambient and diffuse color we use with the V color, the color map. In addition, the lighting uniform structure, you can see light uniform structure, contains several fields here. Most of them are similar to those used in the last example, except for this is two-side field. This field controls whether the lighting is applied to one side or two sides of the surface. Setting this field to 1 means two-sided lighting, while setting it to 0 means one-sided lighting. For two-sided lighting, we apply the light to the back face by adding the lighting with reverse normal vector to both the diffuse and specular lights. You can see here, this is from the side, the same as before, but right now we add back side. You can see the diffuse, the original diffuse front side plus this term. This term is the same as this one, but we reverse the normal vector with a negative sign here. So this means the positive n means the front side, the negative n means backside. So we add this term backside to the diffuse and also to the specular light here. This n dot h is minus n dot h for the backside lighting. This way, we apply the lighting to both sides of a 3D surface. Here, we only consider a simple case, that is, the color of each vertex is the same on both sides of a surface. If you want to apply different colors to each side of the surface, you can let the fragment seeder determine whether the front or back facing color should be applied by using the built-in front facing variables. Here we just assume the color is the same for both sides. Now we can save this file. Since the color map model with lighting in WGPU looks very involved, so I will stop here for today. In next video, I will show you how to create simple 3D surfaces. Thank you for watching.